This is the art of letting go.
Letting go, letting go.
Mike Brown with the vocals.
All right, so yeah, this is Wayne, our alpha.
And this is Mike Brown.
And this is the art of letting go. So what are we talking about today, brother? What we letting go of?
We are talking about letting go of overthinking. That has been something I've probably been doing my entire life. And I'm starting to see now, and I guess with everything that I let go of, I start to see how it affects my life. But more specifically, just how overthinking affects my decision making. It's really has a negative effect on how I see everything. So, you know, I don't know. I'm even overthinking talking about this right now, like just being real. But yeah, overthinking is crazy. And, you know, it's almost like self-sabotaging.
Yeah, man, you're right about that. We just had a whole conversation about my particular project and overthinking it. And I know I overthink everything in life. I've always overthought the overthink of the overthought. That was a bar. It wasn't really a bar. But anyways, yeah, man, I've definitely done the same thing. I feel like I overthink my jump shot. Like, I overthink playing defense. Like, it's not just like, oh, a big decision kind of thing. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's literally a lot of the things that I do. And, you know, I've always thought I was talented in different arenas, basketball being one of them. But yeah, man, I'm overthinking this conversation right now too.
No, but you know what? I feel you though, because I was thinking about just my whole basketball career, and I've always felt like I was a good player, but I never really played to my full potential,
right?
Because I always was thinking too much, thinking about how I should play. And it really wasn't until this summer. Shout out to my teammate, DeMarco. But my teammate made me recognize that I think too much on the court and I need to just play. And, you know, another thing that helped me, and not to say that it's just like the, you know, the cure for everything, and it could be, but smoking. You know, I smoke weed, and it was a couple of times where I would smoke before games and I just wouldn't think about it. And I would just play and I would go out on the court and have fun. And I'm starting to do that more with everything that I'm doing. You know, we've been freestyling every time I come over here, maybe three songs a day. And I find that it's getting easier because I'm not thinking about what I have to say or being the best or any of that. Like, it's just about having fun. And the more fun I have with everything, the better I am at it. So
it's just not with the small things. So that's just an example, right?
Yeah.
So basketball was the example that we both kind of wanted to use. When it comes to overthinking, I think it's kind of simple for everybody to kind of, I feel like everybody overthinks to a certain extent. I know you said weed really helps you. I think for me, I just need to get out and be around people. Like, I spend a lot of time, you know, going to work, coming home, sleeping, going to work, coming home. And I think I got kind of used to just being by myself a lot. So me kind of going out, re-engaging with people helps me not overthink as much when I am by myself. Because that's typically when it happens for me. Like, when I'm by myself, I overthink. When I'm out in a crowd, I'm with other people, it's all like impulse. It's all reaction. Like, it just comes out of me naturally because, oh yeah, yeah, we vibing. Like, there's other people around, you know what I'm saying? There's other energies around. But when I'm by myself, I get to questioning myself because it's a lot of self-talk that I end up doing. Like, I'm in my head. I might say something out loud and I might question. I might love something one minute and then hate it the very next minute, you know what I'm saying? And so I have to engage with, I mean, weed helps you engage, but I have to engage in order to really get over that. And I keep telling myself to do it more. I'm getting better at doing it more. I've gone out more often. This is crazy just talking about all this. But I need to keep doing it. I need to keep at it. Keep at it. Keep working. Keep doing stuff that I don't feel like doing, because I don't be feeling like engaging at all. I just want to chill. You feel me? But except for with the people that I'm really cool with. Like, I like to vibe with the people I'm cool with. But other than that, I don't really want to do it. But I really do want to do it. And I need to do it. That's the thing. Like, I tell myself I don't want to do it, but I really do want to do it. I'm just lazy. That's really what it boils down to. I know we kind of getting on different stuff, but
no, it's all good. It's all good.
It all kind of runs together, you know what I'm saying? So for me, at least.
Yeah.
But it's good to talk about it. It's good to get it out. Like, sometimes you just need to process and talk.
Yeah.
To somebody.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? Even if it's a therapist or a friend that can have an honest conversation with you and don't just like want to talk.
But yeah, talking definitely helps me too. And I forgot that. Not that I forgot that talking helps me, but
right,
just having conversations and saying things out loud. Like, a lot of times when I'm thinking something and I say it out loud, sometimes it helps me process it a little different. It's like, that shit ain't make sense.
Right, or, right.
Yeah, that shit is real. So, you know, sometimes I do have to validate myself and talk to myself and just check in with myself in general to really see where things are at.
Yeah. It's good to self-reflect. It's good to have that introspection or introspective piece of yourself. Introspective. I still feel like I said it wrong. But it's good to do that. Like, to self-reflect, to really look at everything. But then it's like a double-edged sword, you know what I'm saying? Because it's good to self-reflect, but then it's not good to overthink. So it's like, where do you find that happy medium and that balance? You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, let me think about myself and really figure out, like, is this good about me or is this not good about me? Or should I change this? Should I be better at this? And then it's like, well, I'm thinking about all of this too much instead of just doing a lot of the stuff. And so it's a healthy balance that you kind of have to find for yourself. And whatever it is that helps you find that balance, do it. You know what I'm saying? For me, it was music. Like, music really opened me up to expressing myself because I wanted other people to hear my art. And so it caused me to start to engage with other people who did art so they could hear it. And so I could get better. Like, a part of it was I just wanted to get better at it. And so I knew I needed to be around other people to get better at it.
Yeah.
And so it made me start to engage. And then it made me express myself. And so everybody has a different thing. Like, music just happened to be my thing. I think working out and acting and all of that stuff. Once I get back into my flow, I think that equilibrium is going to be good.
Like we always say, this is the art of letting go.
Letting go. Letting go. I'm going to get higher. I'm telling you. It's coming.
Hit us up. Let us know what you think.
Yes, yes.
You know, share some feedback. Share this podcast. And we appreciate you listening. This is Mike Brown.
This is Wayne. This is Alpha.
And this is the art of letting go.